scale for 600 population, x square is equal to twice x into bx. Okay, this is 17th question, x square into cos twice. Okay, now let's using bypass again. This is trigonometric algebra equation. First function, second function. First, this is second function. So using bypass method, using BP method, we get or we obtain sine of integration x square into cos twice x into dx equal to, now x square as it is, integration of cos 2x into dx minus sine gdx of x square into integration of cos 2x into dx only x. This will give us x square cos 2x integration is sine 2x upon 2 minus sine differentiation of x square is twice x, cos 2x is sine 2x positive upon 2 cancel out. Okay, so this is what we have. Okay, got this is sine 2x minus sine. Now here it is further integration x sine 2x into dx. Bypass method again using first function, this is second function. Using bypass method here, x square upon 2 into sine 2x minus sine. Now x function is right within a bracket, minus sine is here. We can use x as it is, integration of sine 2x into dx minus sine gdx of x into integration of sine 2x into dx whole dx. Okay, so this will give us x square upon 2 into sine 2x minus sine. This is x, integration of this will be sine 2x will be negative. Let me first write this whole value. This is minus x into sine 2x means minus cos 2x upon 2. Minus sign we have substituted. Minus 2. This is minus minus plus here. It will be only 1. It will be cos 2x upon 2. It will be negative. So negative sign, positive it has become. But with minus this sign, we open this whole. This is x square upon 2 into sine 2x. Minus minus plus here. This is x upon 2 into cos twice x. Minus is minus sine, sine of 1.2 here, this is 1.2, with minus sine. Now integration of cos 2x is sine 2x positive upon 2. Okay, plus constant of integration. We have 4 is LCM. So let me take common 1.4. It will give us twice x square into sine 2x. Okay, plus sine 2x into cos 2x minus sine sine 2x plus constant of integration. This is the final answer here. This 4, 2 into 2, 4 we have taken out, 1.4. Yet there is no, only 2 is there, so 2 will come here. Twice x square into sine 2x. 2 will also come here, twice x into cos 2x. And this is minus 1 into sine 2x and sine 2x. This is the answer. Final answer is this. This is question number 17th we have done. Now let's talk about 18th question. Now question number 18th let's talk about. Question number 18th. Now, what does it say? Question number 18th. Now let me talk about question number 18th. Okay, 18th question is sine of integration tan inverse x. Okay, this is tan inverse x. Now we have to apply, because tan inverse x integration we do not know. So we have to integrate this with the help of bypass method. In that case we have to take 1 in multiplication of this as second function. So we can say that tan inverse x, and there is no integration of a there is no integration or integral of tan inverse x. So we consider it for differentiation, for like differentiation, and one for integration. Because one can be integrated, not tan inverse x. So we can write it as, therefore, this whole is called tan inverse x into dx. Dx is equal to sine of integration tan inverse x into 1 into dx. We can write this is 1. Now 1 is second function, tan inverse x is first function. Then it can be using bipartite method now. Using bipartite method. Right here, so using BP method, we get. We obtain tan integration of this as tan inverse x as it is integration of 1 into dx minus sine ddx of tan inverse x into integration of 1 into dx whole dx. So this is tan inverse x as it is integration of 1 is x, so let me write x first minus sine. This is integration of, for the differentiation of, now integration of differentiation of tan inverse x, that is 1 upon 1 plus x square. We know differentiation of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square into x into dx, because integration of 1 is x. Now this function is x upon, let me write it as 1 upon tan inverse minus sine x upon 1 plus x square into dx. Now this question is cannot be integrated with the help of bypass method. Now let's stop what's the substitution method. If I consider in this part, okay, let 1 plus x square equal to t substitution. Let's substitute 1 plus x square of twice x, differentiating it with respect to t. With respect to t, we get twice x into dx upon dt equal to 1. Or twice x dx equal to dt, or x into dx equal to dt upon 2. We have x dx, dt upon 2. That means it can be written as x into tan inverse x minus sine 1 upon 2 sine of integration. This is dt upon t. Okay, and it can be integrated as x tan inverse x minus 1.2. This is log of t plus constant of integration. This is x into tan inverse x minus 1.2 log t. What is t here? T is 1 plus x square. Okay, finally, answer must be in x only. This is answer. X tan inverse x. This is x tan inverse x minus a half log under root, or it can be just taken as x into tan inverse x tan inverse x minus log of under root 1 plus x square. We can take this half over the power of log, because this is plus constant of integration, power of log of 1 plus x square. This is half over square root of 1 plus x square. Final answer is this. This is your final answer. Okay, so question is either this answer or this can be taken as answers. Okay, so question number 18th we have done. Let's talk about 19th question. And question number 19th, what does it say? Question number 19th now. Question number 19th is sine inverse x. Okay. Whenever inverse functions are given alone, they are not integrable. They cannot be integrated. We have to multiply 1 into this. Consider 1 as second function, inverse x again. Not integrable. it can witness sine inverse x into 1 into dx. Now using BP method, I have already explained that using BP method we get sine inverse, I'm sorry, this is sine inverse, what I'm doing. That was sine inverse x into 1 into dx. Sine inverse x as it is integration of 1 into dx minus sine ddx of sine inverse x into integration of dx whole dx. Integration of 1 dx or only dx. Okay, so this is nothing but sine inverse x into x, let me write the x first, minus sine of integration of sine inverse x is 1 upon under 1 minus x squared into integration of dx means 1 is x into dx. Again, we can consider 1 minus x here as t. So it can be integrated in substitution by substitution method. This is x into dx upon x into dx upon under root 1 minus x squared. Sorry. From that, minus x squared equal to t, differentiating it with respect to t, we get this is minus twice x into dx upon dt equal to 1, or minus x into dx equal to dt upon 2, or x dx equal to minus dt upon 2. Okay, so this is can be x sine inverse as it is minus this function. This is minus sine, this minus sine positive sign. So dt upon 2 is 1 upon 2 under root t. Okay, under root t can be taken in the numerator. Okay, x sine inverse x plus half, it can be taken as minus half into dt. Can be integrated now. This is x sine inverse x plus half integration of t minus half over and t is called minus half plus 1 upon minus half plus 1 plus constant of integration. It will give us positive half, minus half plus 1 is positive half, 1.2. That 1.2 and half cancel out. It's nothing but x into sine inverse x plus sine. This is under root t only, t is for half. That means under root t plus constant of integration. Further, it can be written as x into sine inverse x plus sine under root t means value of t is 1 minus x squared. 1 minus x squared plus constant of integration. This is the answer here. Okay, so this is a final answer. Question number 19th, now we have done. So this is question number 19th. Now let us talk about 20th question. Now question number 20. Now question number 20th, what does it say? Let me change it. Now question number 20. Question number 20 is the cot inverse x. 20th question, sine of integration, this is cot inverse x into dx. Again, this is alone, cannot integrate it, so we can consider it as, sorry. This is cot inverse x into 1 into dx, not using bypass method or BP method. We get, it will be, okay, therefore, sine of integration cot inverse x into 1 into dx is equal to, now cot inverse x as it is, integration of 1 into dx minus sine ddx of cot inverse x into integration of 1 into dx whole dx. It will give us here. Cot inverse x into x minus sine. Now, what is the differentiation of cot inverse x? That is minus 1 upon 1 plus x. It will only minus, so it will be plus 1 upon 1 plus x squared in the sign of integration into dds of 1 is x into dx. Why? Because let me write here ddx of cot inverse x is minus 1 upon 1 plus x squared. Since this, therefore we have written here cot inverse x ddx is minus sine. Minus sine is already there, it is positive. Minus 1 plus a. Okay. So finally, we will get x into cot inverse x minus, okay, this is plus sine. Now we can integrate this as by assuming. Now let x square plus 1 equal to t, differentiating it with respect to t, we get is twice x dx equal to dt, that is right, or x dx equal to dt upon 2, or x dx is dt upon 2. We can write it there, x cot inverse x plus sine, this is dt upon t. Okay, so we can further integrate this. This is x cot inverse x plus sine log of t plus constant of integration. X into cot inverse x plus log of t is what t is 1 plus x square, we assumed, plus constant of integration. This is the answer here. The final answer is this one, question number 20th. This answer. Now let's talk about 21st question. Question number 21st. Okay, so let us talk about question number 21st. Now question number 21st. Sign of integration, it is log x whole square, right? Log of x whole square into dx. Again, let us take one as multiplication of it as second function dx. But this is a lone function, cannot be integrated. We cannot integrate log x. So integrating log x is not possible. In that situation, we take one as multiplication of it as second function because one can be integrated. So using now pi parts method, using VP method. So we get this whole equal to, or let me integrate directly. Therefore, this is equal to 1 log of x whole square as it is integration of 1 into dx minus sine ddx of log of x whole square into integration of 1 into dx whole integration. Okay, this is our whole dx. So now let me write here, this is integration of x, 1 is x, so x into log of x whole square, we can write. Now differentiation of log x whole square, it will be twice first 2 into log of x into differentiation of log x is 1 upon x, sorry, 1 upon x into 1 is x here. Integration. So, integration of 1 is x, so x upon x cancel out. This is by function of a function method or chain rule to log x, but log x is still not differentiated, log x is again differentiated 1 upon x. So, this is 1 upon 2 into log x into 1 upon x, x is cancelled out into dx. Again, apply for this single log x again, twice log x, log of x whole square minus 2 into sine of integration only log x into dx. Again, it is to be taken as by parts method because 1 is to multiply to this. Using by parts method again, let me write it using VP method again. Using VP method again, we get it will be x into log of x whole square as it is. No change here, only this one is to change. Let me take minus 2 common. Now log x as it is differentiation of one into dx minus sine, differentiation of log x into integration of one into dx whole integration or whole dx. We will have now x into log of x whole square minus sine twice log of x into x, that here x, twice x into log x, because this is x. Okay, minus sign is minus minus plus here, plus twice into integration will be 1 upon x, and this is x here, x is something out into dx. Okay, one more step, x log x whole square minus twice x into log of x plus sign. Okay, x is cancelled out, only 1 into dx, that means twice into x. Okay, plus constant of integration. Why? Because here nothing is left, x upon x cancelled out. So it's cancelled out. Only 1 into dx, that means x on the integration. Integration of 1 is x here, twice into x, plus constant of integration. Now this is the answer here. For x, okay, x log x can be taken. For the x is taken for common out of this. So here it is x log x squared plus 2 minus 2 into log x plus 2. Okay, that can be summarized well. Let me write here log x and x. Sorry, only log x, x common. Let me take x from, it will be log of x whole square minus 2 into log x, this one, plus only 2, that's constant of integration. Okay, so in this way also it can be written, summarized value, this is further simplified. This is question number 22nd, sorry, 21st. Now let's talk about question number 22nd. Now question number 22nd, what does it say? Question number 22nd. So here, question number 22nd is defect. Okay. Question number 22nd. Okay, so it's log x upon x square. Sign of integration, it is log x. Log x upon x square into dx. Okay, now again, is some x square. Log x cannot be integrated, it's the first function. Log on x square is second function. It can be integrated. Now let me using bypass method. So let me write it as log x as the first function into 1 upon x square as the second function using BP method. Using BP method or bypass method. We get this whole equal to, now log x as it is, integration of x to the power minus 2 into dx, we have taken it in the numerator, this is minus sign, differentiation of log of x, okay, into integration of x to the power minus 2 into dx whole dx. This is whole dx. Okay, here it is. Now let me take it as log x and differentiate, sorry, integration of this is minus 2 plus 1 x, sorry, this is minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1 integration minus sign, integration of, sorry, differentiation log x is 1 upon x, it is again minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1 into dx. So what do we get? This is log of x with minus sign here, minus sign log of x into upon x, because x to the power minus 1 will be there. So x to the power minus 1 means 1 upon x, we have it here. Minus sign, this is minus sign, positive sign. Okay, this is 1 upon x is already there, into 1 upon x will also come. This is 1 upon x, x to the power minus 2 plus 1 means minus 2, 1. X is for minus 1 is 1 upon x, 1 upon x, we have it here. This is 1 upon x already, 1.x into 1.x is negative sine minus sine positive sine. It has become. So here it is minus log of x upon x plus sine. Sine of integration x is for minus 2 again. X is for 2 in the denominator. It will be x is for minus 2 in the numerator. Again it is integrated. Minus log of x upon x. It will be x is for minus 2 plus 1. For minus 2 plus 1 is constant of integration. Minus log of x on x. It is nothing but minus sine 1 upon x. That's constant of integration. Why? This is minus 1. X is for minus 2 plus 1 is x is for minus 1. 1 upon x is a negative sine minus sine. So this is the answer. We can take minus 1 upon x common. It will be log of x positive plus 1 plus constant of integration. Further summarized is the answer. This is the answer here. Either this or that is the answer. Okay, so this is question number 22nd we have done. Now let's talk about 23rd question. Now question number 23rd. Okay, question number 23rd, what does it say? Okay, so all the testers we have used, no problem. Now question number 23rd. Alright, 23rd question. Sine of integration, this is x squared into log of x whole squared. Okay, into ds. Now again, log. L is the first function and x square L your function is second function. This is the first function, the second function. So using by parts, using BP method, we get, it will be first function, that means log of x whole square as it is, integration of x square into dx. Minus sine ddx of log of x whole square integration of x square dx whole ds. Okay, now this question is okay, so using the method is all equal to this. Now next question is what? Let's talk about this log of x whole square upon into x cube upon 3. Okay, this is into x cube upon 3. Integration of x square is x cube 3, 2 plus 1, x cube upon 3. Minus sine, here it is differentiation of first is twice log x into ddx of log x again, it is 1 upon x multiplication into this is x cube upon 3 into dx. Because integration of x square here also. So 1x is cancelled out twice, 2 upon 3, let me write here, 1 upon 3 into x cube into log of x over here. Minus sign, the 2 upon 3 is taken out. Sign of integration, this is x square into log of this. Further differential, further bypass method we have applied. Here it is log x only, 2 upon 3 we have taken out, is x square only. So again log x is first function, this is second function, as the function is second function. Okay, this is first function. Let us take using bypass method again. Using BP method again. BP method again. We obtain. To be obtained here, but this is same thing, 1.3 x cube into log of x whole square minus sine. Now 2.3 common integration of this log x as it is, first function as it is, integration of second, that means x square into dx minus sine ddx of log x. integration of x square into dx, whole dx. Okay, so this is the value. That means for the solvent, this is x cube into log of x whole square minus sine 2 upon 3. Here integration is x cube upon 3, let me write first, x cube upon 3, so x cube into log of x as it is, it is x cube upon 3, let me write later log of, it will be, let me write log of x as it is, this is x cube upon 3 minus sine, differential log x is 1 upon x. Integration of x square is x cube upon 3 into dx. Now log x is removed. So once more it is power 2. So it is 1 upon x cube into log of x whole square minus sine, this is 2 upon 9. In the first one, this is x cube into log of x minus minus plus here. 2 upon 9 again, this is 9, 3 will come out, 2 upon 9 also, and the integration is x square into dx, okay, 2 upon, this 2 upon 3 into 3, this 2 upon 9 plus sine, 1 plus, okay, now this is the last step, let me further write it, 1 upon 3 x cube into log of x whole square, with minus sign, with minus 2 upon 9 x cube into log of x plus sign, it is 2 upon 9 into x cube upon 3. What the point? X cube over is 3. X cube upon 3. Integration of x square is x cube upon 3. The final answer plus constant of integration. Final answer will to let me write here the answer, final answer that will give us 1.3 into x cube into log of x.